डियर लर्नर्स, माई सेल्फ विपुल कुमार डी प्रजापति, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर एंड एचओडी फार्मास्यूटिक्स, एसएसआर कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मेसी सिलवासा, वेलकम यू टू दिस सेशन 7 ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल इंजीनियरिंग अबाउट डिस्कशन ऑफ रोटरी ड्रम फिल्टर. द लर्निंग आउटकम्स ऑफ दिस सेशन. After this session 7, you will be able to understand about rotary drum filters, principle, construction, working, merits, demerits, and various uses. First, what is a rotary drum filter? It is a type of filtration equipment operated either by vacuum or pressure in industry for continuous filtration operation to collect valuable solid constituents as a filter cake by surface filtration or straining mechanism from a slurry containing high proportion of solids in between 15% to 30% weight by volume. Where is the rotary drum filter under the classification of filtration equipment? It falls under the continuous process driving force, either pressure or vacuum, but mostly under the vacuum it works. So this is the rotary drum filter. Now we are discussing about invention of rotary drum filter. It was patented in England in 1872 by William and James Hart. Because of its versatility and simplicity, it is one of the most widely used vacuum filters. In 1906, Oliver discovered the new model of rotary drum filter, hence it is namely as Oliver filter. So it is another name of rotary drum filter, that is Oliver drum filter. Its basic design varies with different manufacturers, such as first variety, vacuum is created within compartments formed on the periphery of the rotary drum, and second design, vacuum is applied to the whole of interior of the rotary drum. But most frequently used continuous rotary drum filter is first type of design, means vacuum is created within compartments formed on the periphery of the rotary drum. This is the first design of rotary drum filter. First image and what are the different connection with this rotary drum filter are available. The features of first design of rotary drum filter consist of the metallic cylinder mounted horizontally having 2 meter in diameter and 3.5 meter in length, perforated surface, that is outer cylinder, which gives surface area approximately 20 square meter, filter cloth of high strength, desired porous structure is mounted on the surface of outer cylinder. The internal pipes are connected that provides the different sections, and they are directly linked with the rotary valves and attached to the pumps and different receivers. The rotating valve is there, and the whole rotary drum is dipped in the slurry containing froth. So these are the few features of rotary drum filter. Why this first design of rotary drum filter is most frequently used? As vacuum is created within compartments formed on the periphery of the rotary drum, It gives maximum versatility and low cost per unit area. And second reason is it allows a wide variation of the respective time periods devoted to filtration, washing and drying steps. Hence, the first design of rotary drum filter is most frequently used for continuous filtration operation. When we require rotary drum filter, the first reason is when a continuous automation solid liquid filtration of a slurry containing high solid contents is desirable. The second reason, when a large scale or long run filtration for continuous removal of solids from a slurry of high solid contents is desirable. At that point, the other filters are not used, such as filter leaf, plate and frame filter press, because of clogging the filter media. And third reason, robust construction of filtration equipment for reliable operation or efficient mechanical separation work with minimum labor requirement for maintenance as well as for operation. Hence, due to its robust construction as well as reliable mechanical separation work with minimum labor requirement for maintenance as well as for operation, it is highly preferred. So at that time, rotary drum vacuum filter is suitable for mechanical solid liquid filtration unit operation. Now, what is the principle of rotary drum filter? Normally, it is a type of surface filtration. Means the separation of solid liquid mixture, that is slurry, is achieved by a porous filter cloth held on a perforated base of rotary continuous filter under the principle or mechanism of straining or screening or sieve-like. This rotary continuous filter rotated through the pulp or slurry with applied vacuum to the inner surface, causing solids to accumulate on the surface of filter cloth as a cake or layer through which the liquid is drawn. So normally the rotary drum filter's principle is surface filtration by straining, screening or sieve-like mechanism under vacuum. With this, the solid liquid continuous filtration, washing of filter cake and its partial drying as well as discharge of filter cake all take place automatically. Now, what is the construction of rotary drum filter? As shown in figure, it consists of two hollow concentric metallic horizontal cylinders or drums with perforated surface. The outer metallic horizontal cylinder is perforated and of 2 meter in diameter and 3.5 meter in length, giving an area of 20 meter square or larger than that. So according to the requirements, its design is carried out. Normally, the length is greater than the diameter of the metallic horizontal cylinders. It is mounted on horizontally on a hollow cylinder. The annular space of the drum are divided into separate compartments by radial partitions. And the perforated outer drum is covered with a filter cloth of suitable strength and pore size, so it acts as a filter media. The region between the two cylinders is divided longitudinally into several sections of five zones. So what are the different five zones we are discussing in next slide? So this is the construction of rotary drum filter. It indicates what is the internal view of rotary drum filter. This is the typical layout of rotary drum filter. The perforated outer surface and the centrally hollow and mounted horizontally. So it indicates all sections along with perforated base of drum, annular pipes, valve of compressed air, dry air, slurry as semi-cylindrical tank and agitator as a stirring devices. So the internally it consists of face plate, wear plate connected with rotary valve and how it works. So this is the most important part of rotary drum filter, that is rotary valve. So this figure itself indicates internal cross section of the rotary drum filter and the remaining portion indicates the perforated base and how the cake is deposited and scraping of the cake is carried out. What are the different zones of rotary drum vacuum filters? The rotary drum filter is divided into five different zones for a complete filtration operation, such as the first zone is known as pickup or cake building zone. The second zone is known as drainage or filtering zone. Third zone is known as washing zone. The fourth zone is known as dewatering or drying zone. And last one is known as cake removal zone. All these five zones are having different position and function, as well as they are attached to the ancillary equipments. First one, pickup zone. Its position in slurry trough means semi-cylindrical tank containing slurry, and its function vacuum is applied under vacuum. It work. It is attached to filtrate receiver. Second zone, drainage. It function. It is attached with the vacuum and filtrate receiver. Next is washing zone. Its position as wash press, so water for washing inlet on the washing zone is carried out. Function vacuum work on it and it is attached to washed water receiver. Fourth zone is drying zone. Vacuum is applied and here wash receiver is connected. And last is cake removal zone. It is positioned at scraper knife. Compressed air is applied here, means blower, and the cake conveyor is attached with this cake removal zone. Each section of a zone is connected to a centrally located rotary valve via an internal pipe to one hole in the rotating plate of the rotary valve. The valve acts in such a manner that one third portion of the drum is under vacuum, that is immersed in the slurry containing tank. The adjacent half of the drum is also under vacuum but could be switched to dry air pressure. The remaining portion of the drum is under positive pressure, which helps to dislodge the cake from the drum surface. So positive pressure is applied at remaining portion of the drum for dislodge the cake from the drum surface. The drum is provided with automatic filter valve, filtering tank with slurry agitator and scraper or doctor blade for cake discharge. The speed of drum is controlled through a control panel. So speed of drum is very important factor for desired filtration. A separate semi-cylindrical tank is also a part of the construction, which is made up of either heavy metal, highly resistant towards the corrosion, or thick inert plastic, which is used for handling of slurry feed from the slurry containing tank and connected to a tank of slurry through a pressure pump. So slurry is continuously fed in semi-cylindrical tank from the main slurry containing tank. The drum is immersed approximately about 40% section of whole drum in a semi-cylindrical tank containing slurry, which is continuously agitated to prevent settling of solid. Here continuous agitation of slurry is essential, hence stirring devices or different agitators are available or fixed in slurry tank, because the solids are going to settle and it minimizes the efficiency of filtration by rotary drum vacuum filter. To minimize sedimentation, stirring devices are fixed in semi-cylindrical tank containing slurry. The drum rotates about its horizontal axis in a slurry tank at a very low speed of about 1 revolution per minute, or sometimes in between 0.1 to 3 RPM, in order to pass it through various zones of operation to get desired work. Hence, to maintain the thickness of filter cake, which is deposited on the filter cloth of rotary drum filter, it is required to operate at fixed speed. So speed of rotary drum is very essential to get desired thickness of the cake. Most commonly, from the one complete cycle or rotation of rotary drum filter, 1/3 cycle is used for filtration purpose, half for washing and drying of cake, and the remaining for removal of cake. So for one complete cycle, 1/3 cycle is used for filtration, half for washing and air drying of cake, and the remaining for removal of the cake. Now the summary of different parts of rotary drum vacuum filters are as in the construction: hollow cylindrical concentric drums. Second, rotary valves, it is also known as seats or plex valves, vacuum pumps, filtration pumps, vacuum connections, one for filtrate, second for wash water, and third for compressed air, compressor and heater, filter cloths of different strength and pore size, stirring devices and its motor, pure water or solvent connection with shower for cake wash, receivers, one for washing collection, second for filtrate collection, and third for filter cake collection. Discharge systems. Various discharge systems are used for removal of filter cake according to the type of solids present in the slurry. So these are the different ancillary attachment with the main unit are there. So these are the part of the construction. Now few images itself shows how it is going to be constructed. After completion of construction, now we have to learn about working of rotary drum filter. First, check all the connection through control panel of rotary drum filter in order to minimize hazards. The rotary filter drum is submerged in the slurry tank and operates at a speed less than 1 revolution per minute according to the property of slurry and desired goal of collection of solids as thickness. The drum will pick up the slurry on its surface of filter cloth as it comes in contact with slurry. During its rotation, following steps are occurred. So, what are the different steps are going to take place during working? The first step is cake deposition on filter cloth. It is nothing, it is the first zone of rotary drum vacuum filter filtration operation. In first pickup zone, under the application of vacuum, the layers of solids of the slurry start to build up on the filter cloth. By passing the filtrate through the cloth and perforated base of the drum into annular pipes. So, slurry continuously start to move towards the filter cloth and perforated base of the drum due to vacuum, and continuous layers of solids are deposited. A cake of desired thickness, normally 4 inches, is produced by adjusting the speed of the drum. So here speed is required to control. Increase of speed results in the formation of a thin cake and gives higher rate of filtration. The liquid as a filtrate passes through the filter cloth into an internal pipes and valve, and finally the filtrate reaches to the filtrate collecting tank. So this is the first zone. In second zone, it is known as drainage of filtrate. As the drum leaves the first zone, that is pickup zone, it enters in the second zone, namely drainage zone, where excess filtrate is drawn inside under vacuum. In this zone, special cake compression rollers may be included at this stage so that the cake is compressed and retaining minimum amount of filtrate in the cake and improves the efficiency of next operation, that is washing and drying. The third zone, that is washing of the filter cake. When the drum enters in washing zone, the water is sprayed on the compressed filter cake to remove traces of filtrate retained on the cake. A separate system of vacuum is applied in this zone on the panel in order to suck the wash liquid. Wash water or wash liquid is collected into a separate collecting tank known as wash water or wash solvent collecting tank. For this purpose, separate vacuum connector and valve is there. Fourth zone is known as drying of the filter cake. Now, the drum enters in the drying zone where hot air or blow air is blown on the cake to dry the cake and moisture content of the cake reduces to 1% weight by volume. Fifth zone is removal of the dried filter cake. So when the moisture content of the cake is reduced to 1%, finally the drum enters in the zone of removal of dried filter cake. The pressure is applied in this zone under the cloth to aid the removal of the dried cake. And the cake is removed using a doctor knife and discharged into storage or onto a conveying receiver. Now the drum is ready to receive a fresh lot of slurry. The above mentioned operation continues till the slurry gets exhausted. Remember, the cake at the end of dewatering section is compact and tightly bound to the filter cloth. This is indication of how rotary drum vacuum filter works. So this animation itself indicates how in one rotation continuously filtration of solid liquid mixture containing high solid contents separated and the solids deposited as filter cake removed continuously. The process cycle of rotary drum vacuum filter is continuous. Each revolution consists of cake formation, cake washing if required, then drying and cake discharge. This is the another way the slurry is fed from the bottom and overflow of slurry is there and continuously it is recycled until we are getting the filter cake of desired thickness. So this animation indicates how rotary drum vacuum filter works by recycling of slurry. In the cake removal zone, so that is the final zone, two processes take place. The first is known as loosing of the compact filter cake and second is known as discharge of the compact filter cake. First, loosening of the compact filter cake. The cake is loosened by blowing air under high pressure beneath the cake. So cake is going to loosen, hence it is easy to remove from the filter cloth. So blowing air under high pressure beneath the cake is essential. Now how the cake is discharged after loosening? Normally a discharge device will be selected based on the process material characteristics and how readily it is released from the filter cloth. It can be done by different techniques such as first scraper method, second string discharge method, third is known as belt discharge method and fourth one is known as roll or roller discharge method. So first technique of removal of the cake in rotary drum filter, that is known as scraper or knife discharge method. A knife or a scraper is fixed at a small distance from the surface of drum and scrapes away the filter cake from the filter cloth. The knife discharge system incorporates a knife which is arranged so that the surface of the drum runs on or near to the knife edge without damaging the filter cloth. Particularly, it is suitable for friable cakes that do not have the mechanical properties to bridge over the strings of a string discharge system. So this image itself indicates how the filter cake, dried filter cake, removed with the help of scraper or knife. This is the indication of filter cake removed by scraper or knife method. A knife or a scraper will be used if the thickness of filter cake is 3 mm. This is the image of rotary drum filter with scraper discharge method. The second technique of removal of dried filter cake is known as string discharge method. It is effective for an extremely wide range of materials. It is used for cake having cohesive strength and gelatinous nature. So it is widely used for the removing of cake which are cohesive in strength and gelatinous in nature. Strings commonly made of synthetic material like polyester is commonly used. They are kept uniformly spaced using comb. So combing technique is used for fixing the strings on the filter cloth and are placed parallel to each other 8 to 10 millimeter apart and wrapped over the drum surface. Sedimentation of cake takes place on and above the strings during filtration unit operation using rotary drum vacuum filter. Hence, it is required to check continuously and combing is necessary. A schematic diagram shows a string passing over two auxiliary rolls at the end of the cycle. When the vacuum is released at the end of drying zone, the strings help to lift the cake off the drum surface, which is then discharged. So how it is going to be discharged, it itself indicates in the diagram. So this image indicates in zoom condition how the filter cake removed due to string discharge. So strings are fixed on the filter cloth and hence the filter cake continuously deposited on the string and it is removed with the help of return rolls. Third method is known as belt discharge method for removal of dried filter cake. This image indicates same as the string discharge method. Here instead of different strings, number of strings, here belt is used, that is fabricated belt. So the desired strength belt system is used and to minimize the unwanted things during the filtration operation, it is fixed at particular position and regularly it is going to checked in order to minimize the loss of the filter cake. So the belt discharge is used. Normally belt itself work as a open conveyor for removal of dried cake through discharge roller at the end. So belt itself used as a open conveyor and it is versatile to remove all types of cake from filter cloth. Fourth type of discharge technique is known as roll or roller discharge method. The scrap roller is placed against the cake at a suitable distance to slightly compact and peel off the cake from the filtering cloth surface. The surface of the scrap roll is capped with a rubber material to minimize the contamination of scraper in the filter cake. So that's why rubber material is capped on the scraper roll. A scraper knife keeps the scraper roll surface clean. The scraper roll rotates in the opposite direction to the drum. The speed of the scraper roll is 5 to 10% greater than the speed of the rotating drum. The cake is transferred from the drum to a discharge roll from which it is removed by a knife. This is a relatively simple method of removing thin and sticky filter cakes without having a knife. So without knife it can work. So roller discharge method works without knife, rubbing against and wearing the filter cloth. This technique is particularly suited to sticky clayed cakes like that of bentonitic or kaolinitic clays, means bentonite and kaolin containing clays, They are also suitable for highly alkaline red mud slurry produced in the alumina industry's Bayer process. How to get the best result of filtration using a rotary drum vacuum filter? The performance of this type of filter equipment for given feed conditions can be controlled by three main variables. First variable is known as drum speed. Second, the vacuum, if necessary, with differential vacuum applied to the filtration, washing and drying zones. And third variable is known as the percentage of drum surface submerged in the feed slurry. So how it is going to submerge in the feed slurry? It is also one of the variable for its efficient work. So the drum should be run. First is the speed. So drum must be run as fast as possible while still producing a chargeable cake. It operate at highest practicable vacuum, and the drum should be submerged maximum. So by using these three variables, the performance of rotary drum vacuum filter improved. Now the time of reflection spot. You have to pause your video, take your note and pen, and if you know the answer of this question, please answer the question. What are the merits of rotary drum vacuum filter? Think and answer it. If you have completed your answer, play the video and verify your answer. What are the different merits of rotary drum filter? The first merit of rotary drum filter is it is used for an automatic continuous filtration operation. Hence, the labor or operating costs are low. Second merit, due to large surface area of filtration, it has high capacity of filtration. And required thickness of filter cake is obtained by changing its speed of filtration operation. So here speed is control and desired thickness of filter cake is obtained. If an impenetrable cake forming solids as filter cake is required, then its thickness may be limited to less than 5 millimeter. So at that time we have to operate it fast rate. If a porous cake forming coarse solids as filter cake is required, then the thickness may be 100 millimeter or more can be obtained by minimizing the speed of rotary drum filter. So the number of layers are deposited on the filter cloth and its thickness can be controlled. So speed is changed according to the required thickness of the filter cake. So this is the advantage. Next advantage, suitable for filtration of concentrated slurry. So solid contained between 15% to 30% weight by volume can be handled efficiently, continuously, automatic, as the filter cake is removed simultaneously during filtration operation. And last one is washing as well as drying of filter cake is performed simultaneously in continuous filtration operation. So hence these are the merits. Now again, next reflection spot, you have to pause your video, take your note and pen and write down the answer of these questions. What are the disadvantages of rotary drum vacuum filter? If you have completed to answer the question, play the video and verify the answer. The demerits or disadvantages of rotary drum filters are as it is costly filtration equipment. The equipment cost is very high because of required other ancillary equipment such as vacuum pump, vacuum receivers, traps, slurry pumps, agitators, etc. It is a complex filtration equipment due to number of moving parts. It is very difficult to obtain a complete dry filter cake as discharge cake retains residual solvent. So complete dry cake is not achieved. Next, it is less satisfactory or it causes problem in filtration. In case of solids forming an impermeable cake. If solids which are present in the slurry which form an impermeable cake such as example gelatinous or slimy precipitates in slurry, then it gives less satisfactory result because of clogging of the filter cloth and difficult to remove from the filter cloth. Inefficient washing and drying steps of filter cake due to drawing of air by vacuum pump creating cracks, number of cracks in filter cake. So washing and drying steps must be controlled. As vacuum is applied, it is unsuitable for liquids of near boiling point. Otherwise, fire hazards may take place. That's why this is the disadvantage. Next, because it is a vacuum filter, the pressure difference is limited to 100 kilopascal or 1 bar. Yet, some hot filtrates may boil because of reduced pressure. Okay, so to minimize the fire hazards due to liquid required to remove under pressure or vacuum, it is required to operate at minimum pressure difference. The rotary filter is suitable only for straightforward slurries, being less satisfactory if the solids form an impermeable cake or will not separate cleanly from the cloth. So these are the disadvantages of rotary drum vacuum filter. Now again, the next reflection spot, you have to take your note and pen, pause the video and write down the answer of these questions. What are the uses of rotary drum vacuum filters? Think and answer it. If you have completed to answer of the question, you have to play the video and verify it. It is used for continuous operation of solid-liquid separation of slurry containing high proportion of solids up to 50 to 30% weight by volume. That is well known. So continuous automatic solid-liquid separation operation is required. It is widely used. It is used for collection of calcium carbonate, starch and magnesium carbonate. It is also used in production of penicillin in pharmaceutical industry to separate mycelium, that is cell mass, from the fermentation liquor. Often used in water treatment plants to remove large amount of fine sediment from water. Also used to remove wastewater from suspended slurry products. So these are the uses of rotary drum filter. Now again, next reflection spot, you have to pause the video, take note and pen and write the answer of this question. What are the modifications of rotary drum vacuum filters? Think and answer it. If you have completed your answering of this question, play the video and verify it. There are four modifications of rotary drum vacuum filters in order to improve efficiency of filtration unit operation to get valuable desired filter cake. First, cake compression rollers The second is known as pre-coat filters. Third is known as the string discharge rotary drum filter, and fourth modification is known as top charged rotary drum filter. The first one, cake compression rollers. Sometimes in rotary drum filter the cake shrinks and cracks, so there is no efficient washing due to channeling. Hence the special attachment, that is cake compression rollers, are included. These rollers compress the cake to homogeneous mass to improve the efficiency of washing as the cake passes through the washing zone, or to aid drainage of wash water as the cake passes through the drying zone. So that's why cake compression rollers are attached as a part of modification of rotary drum filter. The second is known as pre-coat rotary drum vacuum filter. Why it is required? Pre-coat means we are going to apply filter aid, that is known as rotary drum vacuum filter with pre-coated filter aid. Typically diatomaceous earth or perlite is used to pre-coat the filter cloth of drum. Why it is used? Sometimes solids block the filter cloth and increase the resistance of filtration. Hence a pre-coat filter is used in rotary drum vacuum filter. So pre-coat is nothing, we are going to apply a thin layer of selected filter aid. So first filter aid is deposited on the drum prior to the actual filtration operation of available slurry. So first filter aid slurry is going to apply in rotary drum vacuum filter. So filter aid is deposited as a thin layer on filter cloth and it act as a filter media to improve the rate of filtration and minimize the clogging of the pores of the filter cloth. So filtration is then carried out through this layer, and the doctor blade or knife is so arranged that it automatically progresses towards the drum. A very thin cake can then be formed and the whole of it removed together with a thin layer of the pre-coat material. So to improve the efficiency, if such types of impermeable solids are there and required to remove, so diatomaceous earth or perlite is used as a filter aid, so pre-coat filter is applied. The third is known as string discharge rotary drum vacuum filter. When the cake is difficult to remove or when it is desirable to deliver in intact, especially useful for certain pharmaceutical applications such as filtering the fermentation liquor in the manufacturing of antibiotics, where the mold is difficult to filter by ordinary methods of mechanical filtration because it forms a felt like cake. Hence the cake is lifted by using string discharge. So number of strings are used on the filter cloth and it is fixed having the space between the strings, so number of strings are attached on the filter cloth. So the cake which is formed on the surface of the string is lifted from the filter and discharged by a system of endless strings which pass around the drum over the filter cloth. No discharge knife scraping the filter cloth is required. So here no additional knife required. String itself detached from the filter cloth and discharge of cake is possible. In operation, the strings lift the cake off the filter medium and the cake is broken by the sharp band over the rollers and collected whilst the strings return to the drum once again. So strings are not going to damage and they are made up from polyesters. The fourth modification is known as top charge rotary drum vacuum filter. Means slurry is fitted from the top of the rotating drum filter. Why? It is for the slurries which are unstable and settled rapidly. So the slurry is entered on the top end of the drum and filtration is rapid. So arrangements are made to press the filter keg to dewater it, and the vacuum system aids the entire filtration unit operation. So slurry is fed from the top. When sedimentation of the slurry containing solid particles settled rapidly, so rate of settling of solids are rapid, at that time the top charge rotary drum vacuum filter is followed. So this is the end of session 7. Thank you. Happy learning. If you have any questions, submit it to my email ID. Thank you once again.